Hello, I'm Professor Von Schmohawk, and welcome to Why U. When we first introduced polynomial functions, we saw that polynomials are the sum of one or more monomials. We also saw that if we think of each monomial as a separate function, then a polynomial function can be thought of as the sum of these monomial functions. Although the graphs of monomial functions are relatively simple, the graphs of the polynomial functions produced by summing these functions can be quite interesting and varied. Just as monomial functions can be added to produce polynomial functions with more than one term, those polynomials can be added or subtracted to produce new polynomials with different characteristics. So let's see how the process of adding or subtracting polynomial functions works. To add polynomials, we add all the individual terms, rearranging the terms in order of decreasing exponents, and combining terms that contain the same variables raised to the same powers. As an example, let's add the polynomial functions -3x minus 1 and x cubed minus 1. To add these two polynomials, once again, we add all the individual terms, rearranging the terms in order of decreasing exponents, and combining like terms. So the sum of these polynomials is x cubed minus 3x minus 2. And since these two polynomials each defined a polynomial function, summing these functions creates a new polynomial function. We can see how this process works graphically by looking at the graphs of these functions. We added the function -3x minus 1 and the function x cubed minus 1. Summing two functions adds the values of the functions at every point. For instance, when x is negative 1, the values of the functions are positive 2 and negative 2. Therefore, for that x value, the sum of these two functions is 0. Likewise, for an x value of 0, both functions have a value of negative 1. So for that value of x, the sum of these functions is negative 2. And for an x value of positive 1, the values of the functions are 0 and negative 4. Therefore, their sum at that x value is negative 4. Zooming out a little, we see that when x is negative 2, the function's values are 5 and negative 9. So their sum at that x value is negative 4. And when x is positive 2, the values of the functions are 7 and negative 7. So their sum at that x value is 0. If we were to continue adding the values of these two functions for every possible value of x, we would produce the graph of the function x cubed minus 3x minus 2. Fortunately, the process of adding polynomial functions is much easier than adding the values of those functions at every point. As a second example, let's add the function x plus 1 quantity squared and x minus 1 quantity squared. The graphs of both of these functions are parabolas. Summing these two functions, we get x plus 1 quantity squared plus x minus 1 quantity squared. But what would this function's graph look like? These two functions may not look like polynomial functions, but that's because they are not written in standard form. Squaring x plus 1, we get the polynomial x squared plus 2x plus 1. And squaring x minus 1, we get x squared minus 2x plus 1. Adding these polynomials we get the polynomial function 2x squared plus 2, whose graph is also a parabola. So adding these two parabolic functions produces another parabolic function. Now, what do you think would happen if we subtract function f2 from f1? It is not immediately obvious what the graph of x plus 1 quantity squared minus x minus 1 quantity squared might look like. So let's subtract f2 from f1 and see. As we did before, we will first write these two polynomial functions in standard form by squaring the terms in parentheses. Then, since subtracting a quantity is the same as adding the negative of that quantity, instead of subtracting function f2, we will multiply that function by negative 1. Flipping the signs of all the terms, and add the two functions. So subtracting the quadratic function f2 from f1 produces the linear function 4x. When we graphed the polynomial function x plus 1 quantity squared, we needed two dimensions. One for the value of the input variable x, and a second dimension for the function's output value. We saw that the graph of this single variable polynomial function is a parabola. However, it is important to note that polynomial functions can contain any number of variables. For example, the polynomial x plus 1 quantity squared plus y squared can define a polynomial function in two variables x and y. To graph this polynomial function in two variables, we need three dimensions. One dimension for the variable x, one dimension for the variable y, and a third dimension for the function's output value. The graph of this two-variable second-degree polynomial function is a three-dimensional shape called a paraboloid. So let's see what happens when we add polynomial functions with multiple variables. For example, the function x plus 1 quantity squared plus y squared and the function x minus 1 quantity squared plus y squared. Once again, we put this polynomial in standard form by squaring x plus 1 and rearranging the terms in order of decreasing exponents, giving us x squared plus y squared plus 2x plus 1. Likewise, squaring x minus 1, we get x squared plus y squared minus 2x plus 1. The graphs of both of these functions are paraboloids. Just as with single variable functions, summing to multivariable functions adds the values of the functions at all possible input values, or in this example, every possible value of x and y. And as we saw with single variable functions, the process of adding multivariable polynomial functions is much easier than adding the values of those functions at every point. Adding these two polynomial functions we get 2x squared plus 2y squared plus 2, whose graph is a paraboloid. In this lecture, we have seen how polynomial functions can be added or subtracted. In our next lecture, we will see how to multiply polynomials and use the principles we have learned to design polynomial functions with specific characteristics.